Good morning, God. I want to invite you once again for this new day to listen to the words from our Lord. We will begin reading a verse from Genesis chapter 2, verse 8. And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had formed. The word planted comes from the Hebrew word nata, which actually means to pitch or to plant. So, we normally don't plant trees. We plant seeds, or we plant the plants, or we plant the saplings. And they have to grow and become fruitful. The proof of it is also biblically found in Jeremiah chapter 12, verse 2. Thou hast planted them, yeah, they have taken root. They grow, yeah, they bring forth fruit. So God planted and they have taken root and they have grown. Here is the revelation. One of the reasons why God gave man a physical body is because he needed somebody to till the ground. You understand? To till the ground. Genesis 2:5 says, For the Lord God has not caused rain to come upon the earth, but there was no man to till the ground. So man was given a body to till the ground. So I believe when God began the process of planting to till the ground, man was brought in into the garden. He was brought in into the garden to take care of it in plowing, in seeding, in watering, in trimming. Now, keeping this picture in your mind, read chapter 2, verse 9 from Genesis. It says, Out of ground made the Lord God to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food, the tree of life, also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. So he made it to grow. You understand? He made it to grow. And how? He kept the man in the garden. The proof is from verse 15, chapter 2 in Genesis. And the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. So when such things were on process, one day God would have said to Adam, Adam, these trees would be fruitful one day. You can eat every fruit. But that tree, God would have said, Adam, that particular tree, and there were frows on the forehead of Adam and looking at God's face. And God would have said, that tree of knowledge of good and evil, the day you eat, you will surely die. My father was a Methodist pastor, and he used to say, adding something from his own imagination, he used to say, Adam poured water to this plant called the knowledge of good and evil. He knew it as it was growing. He knew it that one day it would become a big tree and become very dangerous. He would have said to Eve many times, Don't touch that tree. God said it. It is poisonous. The day we eat, we will surely die. Yet he poured water. Yet he let it grow. My father used to say, he would have plucked it out. He would have rooted it out when it was still a plant. But he let it grow. What would have happened if Adam would have plucked that plant, the tree of knowledge of good and evil? Maybe to our imaginations, there will be no limits. But that was not the purpose of God. It need to grow. It need to be there. It need to be there to test man's obedience. Just as the good farmer, the owner of the field, said to his servants that both the good seed and the weeds should grow together. Matthew 13:30, he says, Let both grow together until the harvest. But precisely, we do the opposite to it. We want bad breaks to disappear, defeats never to appear again. Fear, depression, failures like tsunami never exist. If we face them, then we pray, Lord, take it away. Don't let them invade my parameters. Make all my life a bad weather free. Aha! Such a thing is impossible in this fallen world. So the tree have to grow. The tree of good and evil should be there. So what should we aim then? Storms will be there. But we should ask God, Lord, I will walk over the waters as you walked. I will stand in the fire like the three friends of Daniel and will come out unharmed. The fire will not touch me because you are there as the fourth man with me. Amen. So today, irrespective of the presence of storms, fires, earthquakes, bad weather, fear, failure, sickness, breakups, darkness, wickedness, whatever, in whichever way they come, I prophesy, you are an overcomer. Angels will hold your feet, fourth man will hold the heat, the light of the world, Jesus, will hold the darkness. Amen. Go. You're more than a conqueror. God bless you.